friends, welcome back. Today video we are going to talk about swagger. Why swagger? What is swagger? Swagger is a tool, it's a library. Using that we can generate our web service documentation, our web service guide. We can generate dynamically we can generate our web service documentation using swagger library. That is the usage of swagger. What is the use of generating document? In our example, right, where is the controller? Yeah, in our example, stock management controller and the user controller, we have created a two controller, right? This each controller is having a some endpoints, some web service implementation. For example, here adding a new product, then view all product, get product, then update product, then delete product, delete all product. There are some endpoint we have implemented here. Similarly, in the user controller also we have created saving user, viewing user, then view all user, then I created some HTOS example. This will whenever retrieve the user ID, this particular endpoint generate the link for viewing all the user. So this many endpoint I have created already. Okay, now I want to, let's say now I completed my development, I want to hand over this web service to my consumer, nothing but who is going to using my web services. For example, I am a backend developer, I have completed my backend task, I created some endpoints. Now I want to integrate these services in Angular or React, some front-end tool I want to use to integrate my web services. For that I need to provide some guide, I need to provide some documentation through some resource. Okay, through some resource I need to show, I need to give some documentation to my front-end people. Okay, that source is called as a swagger. Using swagger I can generate a documentation about my web service endpoint. Through the documentation they can understand what is the saving user endpoint, what is the request body, and what is the parameter, what is the attribute in the user attribute in the user request body, then what is the response. Like that they can learn from the swagger documentation. That is the use of swagger. Okay. If you want to integrate swagger, we need to add some artifact. Still I have not added any artifact here, but I prepared already. If we are using Spring Boot greater than or equal to 2.2, if you are using Spring Boot greater than or equal to 2.2, we have to use swagger version 3.0. Otherwise we need to if you are using Spring Boot greater than 2.0, we have to use swagger 3.0, this artifact. Okay, if you are using lesser than that, we have to include these two attributes or these two artifact. Okay, now I'll going to copy this. Since I'm using greater than 2.2, I'll going to add this artifact. Added this artifact, then I'll going to, for safer side, I'll going to reload project. It will going to add the libraries, import the libraries, that is resolve the dependencies. Okay, now I have added. Okay, until lesser than 2.2 we need to use these two artifact. Okay, but after 2.2, from 2.2 the Spring Boot framework created a separate starter project for swagger. That is the reason I am adding only one artifact. When you click this particular artifact, you can see here there are a lot of swagger related artifact. Main thing is swagger 2 and swagger Spring Fox swagger UI. These two things is mine. Okay, if you are using lesser than 2.2, we have to add these two artifact manually in our pom.xml. If you are using greater than 2.2, just we have to add our swagger starter project, that's it. it will automatically import this artifact. Okay. Okay, now we have added the artifact. Next step is we need to configure the Swagger. For that, I need to create a Swagger configuration class. New Java class Swagger configuration. I'm saying the name it as a Swagger configuration. Okay. Inside the Swagger configuration, we need to add one annotation called configuration. Since it is a configuration class, I need to add configuration annotation. So whenever start the application, this Java file get read by a Spring Boot application. That is the purpose of our configuration. Then we need to say at enable Swagger 2. That's it. If you say enable Swagger 2, this project eligible to integrate a Swagger. Okay, that is the meaning of that. Okay, this is my configuration file. This is now my configuration information. Okay, now I'm going to copy this line. I'm going to import that. I'm going to remove this. Okay, I'm initializing the Docker API, Docker object, through generate the Swagger documentation. Here, the Docker class constructor, we have to pass documentation type is a Swagger 2. That's it. Okay, now I'm not doing anything, just initializing the Docker class by passing Swagger 2. Let's see what's happening while starting the server. Yeah, server is started now. I'm going back to the browser. Localhost 8082. My port number is 8082. If you want to access Swagger, we have to use Swagger documentation v2/api/api-docs. See here, I'm getting some document information. Let's go through that. When I say localhost 8082/v2/api-docs, Swagger 2.0 description, API documentation, title API documentation, terms of service, some terms of service link, contact does not have anything, license by default provide Apache license. Then what is the host, where this service is available. The service available at localhost 8082. What is the base path? Base path is a slash. Then here I created a two controller, right? Stock management controller, user controller, correct? I created a two controller class. In the two controller class, I created some endpoint, right? Now this two controller, for that two controller, it created a two tags, stock management control and the user control. Okay, it's automatically generating here. This is the error control by default generated by Spring Boot. Then path is this is a two there are totally three controller class. In this three controller, two is I have created. Now for this document, that is the document is available here now. Path, what is a path? To access the endpoint, it's providing the path information. Under path, you can see API products. When you see the under product, where is product, stock management controller, API slash products. API slash products, then get endpoint. Get endpoint, I have a get all products. Correct? Then what is the response of that? Response is 200. Description is okay. Here, what is data type of the schema? Schema says that what is the data type of response? It says array. Array meaning what is the array that contain? That array contain product. What is the definition of that product here? When you go to the definition, go down all the way. Yeah, there's a definition section, right? The definition section, it will say object details. In that, in the view all product, we have seen that the response is array. The array contain products. Okay, I want to see what is the product attributes. When you see here, can you come down, there are, see, there is a product. The product having required object, product name, product price, product stock count. See, there are three required object I need to pass part of this endpoint: product name, product price, product stock count. Then what is the data type of each attribute? Integer, then string, then number. So this is the one way of generating a document using Swagger. Okay, after integrating Swagger in your local machine, go through this one by one, you will get understand. This is something like self-explanatory. Okay, the path says what is the endpoint. When you say products, see, product ID, then user ID, again user ID, then errors, then definition. I created only this much endpoint, right? View all product, view only product, one product ID, view all user, view one user ID. Okay, so these the endpoints, all endpoints available under path. Okay, this is so it's generating some default documentation. Now I want to improve this documentation. It gives some default information, right? API documentation. I want to give some meaningful value here. For that, go here, go to Swagger configuration. Now I want to give some meaningful information. For that, I will going to copy this first line. See here, contact is a class coming from Swagger API. Okay, contact, new contact. I want to give contact name Suresh Stalin, it's my name, and pinepad.com. Pinepad.com is on my site. Something we need to provide. Okay, a meaningful document. This might not be a meaningful, but we have to give some meaningful URL and email, everything. Here I given everything's mine. Okay, this is a contact detail. Then I want to copy this. API info, it's again coming from Swagger library. API info, new API info equal to PinePad API. This is a title. PinePad API description. Then what is the version of this API? 1.0. Then terms of condition URL. If you have any terms of condition URL, you can pass here. Then contact detail. I am passing this contact detail, one of the argument of API info, a constructor. Then what is the license? Apache 2.0, or you can say PinePad 2.0. Something you can say like that. PinePad 2.0. Then again you can copy this and paste it here. That's it. Now I am created the API info. The API info contains API title, API description, and what is the contact detail, what is the terms of services, then what is the version of PinePad. Then I want to tell what is the response in this API, right? When I see here, there is a one section called consumes. Yeah, see here, consumes. each API endpoint having some consume section. That consume section says application-json produce any type of message, star, that is incorrect. My produce is our example gives two type of response. One is XML, another one is JSON. I'm not sure if people remember or not, some classes in the content negotiation class, I explained how to return a XML response as well as JSON response. Okay, our example code, the current code can give both JSON response as well as XML response. So I need to provide both here. How to do that? For that, this is the line. Okay, go here and copy. Produce and consumes. I'm initializing as yet. Arrays of assets application dot slash JSON application plus XML. Okay. Now next line is return. I want to return this docket information. This docket having the now this docket constructor having a only empty configuration, does not have any configuration. I mean there is no customized configuration. This will return predefined configuration, default configuration. So I don't want to do that. Comment out this. Just copy this. Return new docket. Docket of document type swagger 2 dot API info. I am giving the API info. This API info contains what is the API name, API description, the contact details. Then dot produce. What type of response it will produce? It produce both JSON as well as XML. What is consumed? It's consumed both JSON as well as XML. Okay. Now somewhat I customized my API now. Let's see what is the output now. Okay. Okay, now we have successfully integrated the Swagger. We have successfully integrated the Swagger. There is an awesome UI. Okay. Then we need to add some documentation on API level. API level. For that, we can use some API annotation that provided by Swagger. Say, I'll going to copy this entire thing. I'll show you one example. You can try with others. Okay. API operation annotation that provided by Swagger. This API operation, we can provide some description and notes to that API. Say value equal to view product by product ID. Note is a view product. Whatever description relevant to this API, you can add here. Then what is the method type? It's a get method, right? So viewing, it's not a get method. We are adding the product. So we need to say here post. Post. Then response. What is the response? If it is success, that is created, right? If it is 201, that is say created, then not found 404 and the failure 500. Three kind of API response I'm providing here. This the document, this will be reflected in your Swagger UI after adding. Then here product, right? This is the product, it's a request body. This product request body also we can add something. For example, if you go product, here already I have mentioned some validation here. Now I want to give to the our consumer, I want to say product name cannot be empty. This is whenever invoke the API, that time this message will come. But as part of the documentation, I want to provide this information. When through this documentation, consumer can understand product name should not be empty. So I want to provide some documentation here. Okay. For that, we can say API model properties. Go here, API model properties. Product name cannot be empty, the same thing. And API model the class level I can say some documentation about the product, about this particular product information. Something like this is some product request body information. Okay, the model level we can provide a documentation, as well as in the API level we can give some documentation. Each API level you can use these annotations. Okay, let's stop the server and run it. Server is started now. Go back here, refresh it. You see here product it's add product, right? It's add product, yeah, adding a product. Addition product description is what is that product name? Is failure. See here it's coming. This is some product in product request body information that is coming automatically. This particular product post method having a request body. That request body information I have given as a, these are some product request body information I given here, right? This information coming here. Okay, this particular post method accepting the request body, the request body type is a product. For that product I given some documentation here. Okay, then the API response, right? In the API and the product cannot be empty. Where is this? We'll search it. Yeah, in the product name, in the definition section, if you go in the definition section, you can see here the product name I mentioned, product cannot be empty. It's coming here, product cannot be empty. In the top level it says this is some product request body information. Okay, so whatever I have given is reflected here. This is model level documentation. Now here in the stock management controller, in the API level I have given some information. Let's see it's available or not. Oh, I have given wrong description. I have given, okay, we have to give add product, adding new product. Here also I'll going to use same thing, adding new product. Sorry guys, server is started, refresh it. In the product in the part section, api.product, now we should look at the post method. The post method you can see adding new product document is added, the API level documentation. Then the API level documentation I say 201 created, added the 201 created. It says 201 created, added one more thing. By default 200 401 and 400 is adding. I have added under 404 is adding here. I have added additionally one created, right? That is also added here. Let's check in the UI, HTML UI. What's there? Add product. See, the created is coming here. Then see model. This is some product request body information. Examples. The model it's giving that whatever in the product level whatever documentation I have given, that is reflected here, right? Then adding a new product, I'm giving here adding a new product, that is reflected here. So whatever I am adding here using API operation, API response, that is available here as well as this JSON. There are many things are available. If you look at the Swagger documentation, everything is easy only. Okay, this just like a startup for you. From here you can do whatever you want. Yeah, that's it, guys. That's it, friends. From the next video, we're going to see JPA. Okay. If you like this video, please share it to your friends and colleagues. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe it for regular updates. Until then, bye bye from Suresh Stalin.